I have two motor mounts here. One has two rings on it, one has three. Why the difference, and is one better than the other? That's what I'm going to cover in this video.
Welcome to Advanced Construction Videos, where we show you how to tackle rocketry, building techniques, and more. On our website, we sell kits, motors, building supplies, and electronics. So come and learn, shop, build, and fly when you visit us at apogeerockets.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Van Milligan from Apogee Components. Today I'm going to talk about engine mounts and why some have two rings in them and some have three. Now, both of these are for rockets that have through-the-wall fins, and that makes a difference. If you just have surface mount fins, two rings is just fine. But sometimes there's an advantage to putting on three rings. So our first kit with through-the-wall fins that I designed was the Zephyr, and it has an engine mount like this, and it has a second ring that's removable. And the purpose of this is you're going to temporarily install it into the tube like this. Once you get the engine mount in, then you will install the fins, and they go into the little slots like that. And what this allows you to do is to pull that centering ring out and put internal fillets, because that's what gives your through-the-wall fins all their strength. Now you're wondering, well, how am I going to get that centering ring out? And if you see the holes right here, that should give you a clue. Before it's installed, what you'll do is you'll take a piece of string and you'll go in and out through these holes and just kind of weave it in and out. And then when you get to the end, they're just tied together. And then what this allows is that it gives you a handle that you can pull that ring off once it's inside. So again, I can put it on. I want to snug these all up so I can get the ring in. Just like that. So basically what you'll do is you'll temporarily bond the fins in with a little bit of glue along the root edge inside. Once that is dry, then you can pull on this centering ring right here to pull it out. And then you can come back and put internal fillets on the inside. And then once that is dry, then you can put this centering ring back on. So that's why this ring has a bunch of holes in it. Well, sometimes it confuses people. On the Mako, it has three rings, but we're going to install two to start with. And we're going to put that inside. And I need this front ring to go just forward of that. And then the fins go in. And if you're wondering what that slot is for, that's to make sure that the fins only go on in the proper orientation. Then I'm going to take a fin alignment jig. I'm going to make sure my fins are nice and straight. It wants to slide forward on me. Okay, so as you can see, I can now get inside and put internal fillets everywhere on the inside to make sure that those fins are nice and straight and they're rock solid. And then once that glue on the inside is dry, then I can take my final ring and put that on the rocket. So that's why this one has three and this one has two. So there's really no wrong way to do it, using two versus three. It's just that we found that most people like three rings because it's easier to wrap your mind around. You know, you don't have to put that back ring on until everything is glued up inside the rocket. So my name is Tim Van Milligan. This is the Apogee Rocketry Workshop. May the winds be light, may the skies be blue, may all your rockets fly straight and true.